Honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, Her Majesty the Queen and His Royal Highness, the Duke of Edinburgh.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. Your Majesty, Your Royal Highness, on behalf of all of the 3 million people of the city of Los Angeles, it is my great pleasure to welcome you to this city. On prior occasions, we've had the great pleasure and honor to welcome members of the royal family. But this is the first occasion that we've had the opportunity to welcome you, Your Majesty. On prior stops here, it has been about 3 o'clock in the morning at the airport, and we thought that it would not quite nice to disturb you at that hour of the morning. And so we've been looking forward to the time when we could officially welcome you to this great city. Los Angeles is truly one of the great international cities of the world. It is rich in diversity, in terms of culture, heritage, races. They come from all corners of the globe. And it is that diversity that has enriched this city. Part of that diversity comes from British subjects, some who have become American citizens, but all working, living, playing together in peace and harmony with the rich cultural and ethnic heritage of this great city. We are proud of the friendship and the ties of commerce between our country and yours. We are a city which is rich in its commerce, its industry. You will find in our city everything from high technology to aerospace. You will find the great cultural richness in this city. Foremost among the cultural attractions is the great entertainment industry. Many of those in that industry come from your great country. We're proud to welcome you to Los Angeles because we think that by your presence here, you will further strengthen the ties of friendship between our two nations and our two peoples. On behalf of all of the people of this great community, I extend to you a hearty welcome, and I present to you a key to the city of Los Angeles, which is a token of our welcome. Key that unlocks the hearts of all of the people of this great community. We have another formal presentation, which I shall ask the president of our city council to make to you. May I present Councilman Joel Wags.
On behalf of the mayor and my colleagues, our assembled guests, and the people of this great city, it's my honor to present this to you at this time.
City Council. Prince Philip. Mr. Mayor, Mr. President of the City Council. Prince Philip and I are most grateful for the warm welcome you have given us in Los Angeles. Like the earliest Europeans who traveled here centuries ago, we have sailed from the south, stopping first in San Diego, now the second largest city in this great state. There, too, we were very touched by the welcome we received. This same northward journey along the coast of California was made some 400 years ago by Sir Francis Drake, who claimed this territory as Nova Albion for the first Queen Elizabeth and for the Queen's successors forever. I am happy, though, to give you an immediate assurance, Mr. Mayor, but I have not come here today to press that claim. I last visited the United States in 1976 to convey to the American people the good wishes of Britain on the occasion of your nation's 200th birthday. Since then, the city of Los Angeles has celebrated its own bicentennial, and you now look forward to playing host the 1984 Olympic Games. The return of the Olympic Games to Los Angeles is surely a fitting tribute to the international stature of this city. Members of my own family who have visited Los Angeles in recent years have told me of its spectacular development, and the progress which your city has made has gone hand in hand with the rapid and dramatic growth of Southern California. Your major industries have successfully combined the most modern technology with an enterprising approach which many observers have likened to the frontier spirit of the early settlers. That fruitful marriage has made Southern California one of the world's economic powerhouses, in which I am glad to see British companies are playing an increasing role. Earlier in this century, most Europeans probably thought of Los Angeles mainly as the center of the film industry. Since then, your city has become a major cultural capital. The Los Angeles Philharmonic has participated in a splendid joint production of Falstaff with the Royal Opera at Covent Garden. And several British companies, including the Royal Opera, are due to take part in the International Cultural Festival here in 1984. There is another aspect of Los Angeles to which I am happy to pay tribute. Your city is sometimes affectionately referred to as a melting pot. Certainly, this ready acceptance of ethnic diversity cannot fail to impress the visitor, and I'm sure it must be one of the city's major strengths. That same acceptance and celebration of ethnic diversity has been at the heart of the peaceful evolution of the British Empire into the Commonwealth, which is a totally multiracial organization. Some 46 independent nations, representing one quarter of the world's population, have come into being on the basis of the principle of self-determination. Although sovereign states, almost all of them have chosen to remain in the Commonwealth, where they are able to make an effective contribution to the solving of our common problems. As a nation, we in Britain were called upon last year to defend that same principle of self-determination in the Falkland Islands. The support of your government and of the American people touched us deeply and demonstrated to the world that our close relationship is based on our shared commitment to the same values. Together, we face daunting problems. Even this most vibrant of economies has not been totally immune to the effects of recession. But we share with you the strongest possible determination to find a way forward. Britain will continue to work with the United States to seek just solutions for the economic problems of the world. I thank you most warmly, Mr. Mayor, Mr. President of the City Council, and members of the Council, not only for the welcome you have given us, but also for the contribution which your great city is making to the objective which we all share.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you kindly remain in the council chambers until the Queen has departed? Thank you. It's very important, ladies and gentlemen, to allow the royal couple to leave, followed by members of the City Council. So please let them exit first. Thank you.